guys, and welcome back to another video on the channel. And today, I am happy to say that I am joined by the official artist of Bristol City, Jordan Hall. So, Jordan, how are you, mate?
I'm good, mate. How are you?
I'm really good, thanks. So let's go straight into it then. So, obviously, last month you were announced as the official artist of Bristol City after doing stuff with obviously the kits and some stuff around Ashton Gate as well.
Yeah. So
going back to when you're a bit younger, my age, about 11, 12, 13, did you ever know you really wanted to be in either art or something to do with football, or what did you want to be when you were younger?
So going from secondary school, I was always interested in sports. So my first hobby was sport, and it was football. And then going through my school years, I always wanted to be a football coach. So that was my first aim, was to leave school, go to college, and become a football coaching officer in my local community, which I fulfilled for around 9.5 years, 10 years. Very good years, working with young people in my local community into schools and secondary schools, and working their way into college. Some of them did work their way back into the same program that I was on. And that was my first point of my job going into the working world, was football. But I never had that much interest in art as a kid. It was mainly doodling in my art class books and pieces of paper after school. Sport was my first point that I wanted to take up.
Yeah, so obviously, when you've got older, you've started liking art, or you've done some amazing painting and just artwork in general. You can obviously see some in the back of your room at the minute. And then obviously, I'm guessing sometime at the start of this year, you got asked if you would like to do something with Bristol City. So how did you find out they wanted you to do something, and what did you actually end up doing?
So how I come across being the artist for Bristol City is I was doing Bristol City paintings for the players going back around 15 months ago now. So my first one was of Tommy Rowe when he scored the fabulous goal at Birmingham.
Yeah.
So preparation caught my eye quite a lot, really, because it was very passionate. I think it was his first goal for the club at the time,
yeah,
on his debut. And that picture really caught my eye. So I painted it, couldn't get hold of him personally. So I had to do a little bit of research and find his brother. And that's how it came around. So I eventually done around 5 or 6 players during the course of a year. And somehow my paintings landed on the chairman's desk, John Lansdowne. He just asked me to come to a meeting down at Ashton Gate, and we just had a real good chat about what I do as an artist. And just fast forward 12 months, I'm now the official artist for the club, which is a dream come true, to be honest, for myself, is a big achievement, and hopefully we could go quite far in the right direction and getting some more paintings done for the club.
Yeah. So obviously it must have been amazing as a massive sports fan, football fan, when you were growing up to end up in a job that two of your biggest passions you got to do. It's the dream job, isn't it?
That's it, yeah. So working in football was a great achievement for myself, in working with local people. And then taking up the title of an artist is you're fulfilling two dreams in one lifetime, and not many people get to do it, and I'm lucky enough to achieve those two.
Yeah. So obviously, as you said, you've done some paintings for Bristol City before you obviously got the job as the official artist. So you've done some team paintings, you've done some for Sammy Smodic, Casey Palmer, Dan Bentley. So how was it then actually giving it to them and then seeing it on their walls at home, on their pictures and stuff?
So the process mainly is they don't know nothing about it. So it's quite a surprise when I message them, and hopefully they see my message and you get that reply and you don't think it's true. You think it's a fake account. You click on it and they're more than happy to accept one of your paintings, which is a massive achievement in itself because there's such high profile players like playing all over the country, and some of them are internationals or former internationals for the younger age groups. And just getting them to see my artwork is a big achievement. Then them accepting it and you see it on their walls, it's quite surreal. You pinch yourself in the morning, you think, have they actually got it? It's really good to see professional people playing the sport of football with my paintings on their wall in their garage or their gyms that they got at home is quite amazing, to be honest with you. It's quite amazing.
Yeah. So you've obviously done the football as well, other sports as well. You've done some singers and that. You've done some boxers, UFC fighters, yeah, stuff like that as well. And then it obviously came up to then being announced as official artist for Bristol City. And when that really came around, it was the kit release as well. So you've pretty much gone from just doing some prints for players and stuff to doing a whole memorial at Ashley's Gate for it. So how was that actually doing it in the South Stand then?
It's hard to explain. It's crazy to think that I was doing quite small paintings to some people, but quite large to some others. And being asked to be a part of the Ashton Gate 8, doing 8 portraits of the players that had tough times at the club and financially, and then getting to paint them, hopefully I could give them to the people themselves. For them to be published all over social media on the Bristol City websites and being sold in merchandises and getting announced alongside the new home kit, it was a crazy, crazy weekend for myself when it all got announced. My phone didn't stop. It was crazy, to be honest with you. I was on the phone more than I was speaking to my family. So, and then to see it up in the South Stand in the concourse, it's mad. It's incredible to see. Like, it's not many people get to do it. I've been one of the lucky ones to see it, and I haven't seen it in person just yet. I've got to go back down to the stadium quite soon and see it there. And yeah, it's going to be a good day when I see it. It's going to be a very good day.
So obviously, any City fans, you do want to go check that, obviously, when we're allowed back into stadiums after all of this. I know some is self-stand in the corner by the shop and the cafe and stuff like that. So if you want to go see that, it's there. So finally, I'm guessing you're going to be doing more stuff with the club with years to come. Some players as well, other sports, other famous people as well. So do you have any big plans for the future?
Yeah, got a lot of big plans, to be honest with you, especially going with the club itself. We're in talks of doing some other projects going forward. Hopefully we could get something done by Christmas. I've got a lot of stuff here at the moment which they're seeing, which they have seen. They've agreed to it. It's just getting around to getting them down to the club now. Hopefully promotion within the next, say, couple of months if everything goes nice and smooth. Working forward, like thinking ahead, there's a lot that I want to personally do with the club. It's all just got to be arranged and agreed, etc., etc., etc. There's a long process. You can't just go in and say, I want to do this piece of artwork and it will just goes away. There's a lot of behind-the-scenes stuff that you've got to do first. Project-wise, on myself personally, without being away from football, I'm currently in a process of an elephant painting that's hopefully going to be finished by Christmas. That's my next one that I'm going to get right into and hopefully finish it within the next couple of weeks. And that's apart from football. So, yeah, a lot of stuff in the future is just getting right into everything, being in place at the right time.
Yeah. So, finally, obviously, massive football fan of yourself, Bristol City playing tonight. But obviously, by the time this comes out, the Villa game will be done. Hopefully, we get through to the fourth round. So, moving on to Sunday then, what is your score prediction for the Sheffield Wednesday game?
Oh, for the Sheffield Wednesday game, they're going to be a tough team to beat just due to the points deduction that they had at the start of the season. I think they've drawn or won their first game.
1-1
So, yeah, there you go. So is they're going to be all guns blazing in a way. They're going to just come out firing. They need the 3 points. There's a big gap between them and the getting out of the relegation zone. So they're going to come full force. Like they're going to throw everything at us. And we've just got to, hopefully we can just suck up the pressure and counteract and get a couple of goals and eliminate them as a possibility for a deduction of 3 points, which we don't want. So stay at the top of the table as much as we can. We've got a good vision going into this season. Brought four players in, I think it was. Four players in the transfer window, which hopefully they're going to be a good impact. But they've made a good impact already. It's just knuckling down and keeping that spirit high and aiming for the 3 points every game, which you're not going to possibly win every game because it's impossible. But it's going to be a tough game. It is going to be a tough game. We can't take no team for granted. It is the championship. It's a ruthless league. But you've got to be prepared for everything. So hopefully we get the 3 points.
Yeah. So finally, thank you, Jordan, for coming on today. Obviously, you can see some of his prints behind them. A very, very good artist. If you do want to go check out some of his Bristol City players' prints or any sport prints, his link to his website will be in the description below. So, yeah, thank you for coming on, Jordan. Hope you did enjoy it.
You're welcome. You're welcome. Very welcome. Anytime.
So thank you for coming on. Hope you did all enjoy. And, yeah, we'll see you all on the next one.